I'm Soledad O'Brien. Welcome to a special edition of Matter of Fact from Puerto Rico. I'm standing at the very windy San Juan National Historic Site, just above La Perla neighborhood. It lies outside of the walls of San Juan, and its location meant it got hit hard in Hurricane Maria. It's been 18 months since Hurricane Maria slammed into the island with deadly and devastating force. The Category 4 storm made landfall with sustained winds of 155 miles an hour. The official death toll now stands around 3,000, a massive increase from the earlier estimates, which were as low as 16 dead. The storm knocked out power to more than 90% of the island, and in the weeks and months after Maria, locals expected help was on the way. It would take nearly a year to restore power here, and there's still damage across much of Puerto Rico. After Maria, many Puerto Ricans vowed to never be left in the dark again, and their ambitious plan starts at home.
The island from above. Blue tarps cover leaky roofs. Some old power lines are in disrepair. It's been a year and a half, and Puerto Rico is still on the mend.
How bad did things get here?
Very bad. You know, you see, that's my roof.
Joseph Cordero's family lost their roof and power for nearly 4 months.
All this area, you know, the electricity gone fast. Any wind, any rain, the electricity goes.
Even not in a hurricane?
Yeah.
But next time will be different. The Corderos and many Puerto Ricans say they have a homegrown plan to recover from the storms that will surely follow Maria. They call it autogestión, or self-sufficiency.
Están haciendo eso ahora mismo. Están dependiendo de ellos, no de ya de la agencia gubernamental y todas esas
cosas. You want to depend on yourself, yeah, not exactly. The government to rescue you, mm-hmm. if you will.
For the Corderos, autogestión means embracing solar power. It costs $3,400 to install solar panels that power their entire home.
If, you know, another hurricane pass, we have electricity because we don't depend no more for the big plants.
98% of Puerto Rico's power comes from electrical grids like this one in nearby Guayama. They can run on oil, natural gas, or coal. The electricity is carried on lines above ground through rainforests and mountains to get to more populated parts of the island. Ruth Santiago is a lawyer working with Comunidad Coqui, a group of residents who've been lobbying for more than 4 years to replace these plants with solar power.
Community groups and residents are very impacted by this in so many ways. You can hear the noise, that's not the least of which. There's lots of air pollution coming from this plant. Also, the water discharges.
The Puerto Rican Electric Power Authority, or PREPA, was struggling before Maria. They had declared bankruptcy and took 11 months to fully restore power.
This is the communications array, mm-hmm. which is powered by this solar panel array over here.
Solar power helped this fire station in San Juan get its communications equipment up and running 2 months after Hurricane Maria. An NGO called Empowered by Light partnered with the solar energy company Sunrun to install panels on their roof. They've outfitted 11 fire stations with panels since then. Javier Rua Jove is Sunrun's director of public policy.
After the hurricane, there's a new consensus. There's a new paradigm. We all suffered. All social classes suffered. We realized that just lack of power is being in another time and place, which was untenable. It cost thousands of lives.
These panels at an experimental solar farm in Salinas have the capacity to create electricity for up to 2,000 homes. But Puerto Rico's financial crisis means a federal control board is now overseeing the island's finances and is making deep cuts, even as the government says it has ambitious plans.
We have to leapfrog on renewables. But how we ground that? Well, by 2035, we want to be 50% generation for renewable sources. By 2050, we want to be 100% renewables.
What's it going to cost?
So that's about $25 billion in order to see a more resilient, stronger, and obviously more renewable system than the one that we had before.
In Morovis, the power is on, but many residents can't connect because the roofs still leak.
Everybody I talked to had no hope, and it was hard. As I want to say, I don't know what else to say. It was pretty hard.
The residents here also embrace autogestión. Edwin Colon and his neighbors enlisted a New York-based volunteer organization, Heart 911, that's teaching Morovis residents to repair their own roofs.
Next time this happens, I'm not gonna be lost. The worst thing in situations like this is when everybody needs your help and you don't know what else to do. I feel better now.
Residents feeling abandoned by FEMA and ignored by their government are prepared to weather the next disaster on their own.
So do you feel like never again is power going to be an issue for you?
We prepare for everything. You're ready. If they're gonna come on another hurricane more powerful, you're ready. We have God. God is good.
And you have solar power.
Yeah.